Today we're going to talk a little bit about winglets. I recently had an idea for a new winglet type design, but before we get into that, let's go over a little bit about what a winglet is. If you've flown on an airliner in the past 5 to 7 years, you've probably seen a winglet. It's those little fin-looking things on the tips of the wings. A winglet is just a wingtip device that increases the effective aspect ratio of the wing. So first, let's talk about aspect ratio. The aspect ratio of the wing is basically the ratio of the length of the wing to the chord of the wing. So basically, it's how skinny the wing is. The bigger aspect ratio you have, the less induced drag you have. Induced drag is caused by vortices, which is the high pressure air on the bottom of the wing wanting to mix with the low pressure air on the top. This causes a swirling effect known as a wingtip vortice that causes downwash on the wing. Essentially, downwash is just what causes induced drag. So what a winglet does is it delays the mixing of the high and low pressure air and moves the tip vortex behind the wing. This reduces the downwash and the effective induced drag on the wing and increases efficiency. So that's the general idea and the design behind winglets. But now let's talk about winglets specifically on RC flying wings. Typically, winglets are found on RC flying wings not for efficiency reasons, but because they're actually needed for yaw stability. Typically, flying wings don't have tails, and so the winglets just provide a vertical surface for yaw stability. However, if designed properly, they can actually increase the efficiency of the wing. So now let's go ahead and take a quick look at a few winglet designs. I mocked up these wings in Fusion 360 using an MH62 airfoil, which is a common flying wing airfoil for RC planes. Here you can see that we have just a basic wing with no winglet, and then I modeled a wind tunnel around it that we'd use in our CFD software. Next, we have the basic top mount only winglet, as well as a bottom only winglet to compare whether putting a winglet device on the top or the bottom makes a difference, like if one is better than the other. And then we have the most common one found on RC planes is the top and bottom winglet device. In this design, the top winglet portion is actually slightly bigger than the bottom winglet portion. And then finally, we have a new type of winglet that I wanted to test out, and that is a curved winglet. As you can see here, it actually arcs over kind of like a wave as it moves backwards along the wing. And I wanted to test out if this would actually increase efficiency on the wing by kind of going ahead and pre-swirling the air. Keep in mind that I designed these winglets to all have the same height and a pretty similar surface area so that the results are as comparable as possible. So at first I set up the CFD simulations using Autodesk CFD 2019, but I ran into a ton of problems and eventually just scrapped the whole thing and restarted using CFD 2018, which is much better. I used auto mesh settings for the first run, and once the simulations had finished running, I pulled the lift to drag ratio for each wing design and plotted it in Excel so I could compare the efficiency increase versus the wing with no winglet. After that, I went ahead and refined the mesh, so I made a bounding box around each wingtip and refined it to a mesh size of 0.5 centimeters per voxel or per little, you know, however you want to call the meshing thing. I just refined it to 0.5 centimeters. This is still a pretty coarse mesh, but for the nature of this study, it's not super important to have a very fine mesh because the trends are what we're looking at. We're not looking at actual lift and drag forces, but we're looking at the trends to see which winglet actually provides an increase in efficiency. So once I plotted the results in Excel, they were actually pretty interesting. So you can see here, this is the data for the wing with no winglet. We have a lift to drag ratio of about 3.12. So next we'll look at the winglet on top. So the winglet on top provides a lift to drag ratio of about 3.5. This is a 12% increase in efficiency over the standard wing with no winglet. So that's pretty good. The winglet on bottom only provided a 9.5% increase in efficiency. So not as good as putting the winglet on top. So that's interesting and something to keep in mind. The winglet on top and bottom provided about a 12% increase in efficiency, which is slightly less than the 12.2% increase of the top only winglet. And this is without doubt due to the increase in surface area. The more surface area you have exposed to the air, the more drag you're going to create. It doesn't provide as much benefit as just putting the winglet on top, but it's also not detrimental to performance either. It is still an increase in performance. And then the most interesting result, my curved winglet design actually provided a 16% increase in efficiency over this the plain wing, which is really interesting. And honestly, I'm not quite sure why it provided more of an increase than just the straight winglets. But I'm guessing that it's because as the air is wanting to curve over, the winglet actually follows the air's path further back, keeping that high and low pressure more separated until it's even further away from the wing. But I'll need to do more study on this and more test to actually confirm why this is happening. So I hope you enjoyed this video and these little tests I ran on winglets. I'm trying to make these videos every week, going over aerodynamics, 3D printing, basically any kind of engineering. So these will be weekly releases. And if there's something specific you'd like to see or something specific you liked or disliked about this video, let me know down in the comments so that I can include that or fix that in my next video. In the next couple of weeks, I'm actually going to be building a flying wing and 3D printing these winglet designs to test to see if I can see any real world differences. So if you're interested in that, go ahead and subscribe so that you can see that when it comes out. Until next time.